Nakuru Town, the heart of Rift Valley, home to one of the county's most outspoken yet humble activists. Meet James Wakibia, who also happens to be a photographer and a blogger. A very simple and easy personality to spot in town, his works on social media are visible within and outside the town, some of which include the famous Gyoto Damsite cleanup and zebra crossing along Burugichua Road. Wakibia's most heroic moment was when his activism came to the rescue of baby Jeremy.
Her baby has been detained at the Nakuru War Memorial Hospital.
I read it first on national newspaper, and I felt that I needed to do something.
One evening, somebody called me and asked me about the baby, and I gave him the contact of the lady.
I called her and I told her my intentions to do the story online through social media, especially Twitter.
I got baby Jeremy on 18th of December through cesarean section at Nakuru Nursing Home. Then later the doctor informed me that baby had problems in breathing.
He was a premature and he developed difficulty in breathing and required intensive care services, which were only available in War Memorial.
First and foremost, I went through so much agony because when your baby is in ICU, you don't know what to expect, you don't know what will happen. So first and foremost, I went through so much stress, and because my baby was sick, myself, I had gone through the cesarean section, so even me, I was still healing. Around March, I met a reporter, a national reporter. So I told her my plight and they decided to put it on paper. So immediately my story was on paper, then Mr. Wakibia called me.
Hashtag Baby Jeremy, a trend started on Twitter and Facebook, went viral and caught the attention of Nakuru County Assembly Speaker Ms. Susan Kihika, who came to the rescue of the baby. Due to pressure from social media and Wakibia's active tweeting, the county government through the county speaker paid the hospital.
It was joy and celebration at the Nakuru War Memorial Hospital after four-month-old baby Jeremy Osiana finally left for home.
I'll forever be indebted to him because what he did, it's beyond words.
I really admired the blogger because he just called out of nowhere, and I felt his concern.
He was a voice for the voiceless. If people like Wakibia never walked into my office, people out there would not have known the truth.
James Wakibia, Nakuru's Unsung Hero.